everyone. Welcome back. I'm going to try to finish up the bear today. he's coming along quite well. Anyhow, a couple of things I did off camera. I cut his vest out. I just have to sew it and put it together. And I had to cut a heart shape for his nose. Cut a black felt. And you'll see that. There. And I had to cut out three circles. They're supposed to be 1 1/4 inch diameter, but they ended up a little bit bigger than that, and hard for me to cut anything straight in circles. Anyhow, we'll see. That's for the eyes and the belly button. Yep, that's right, a belly button. Anyhow, okay, so. Now, the directions. Anyhow, okay, I just want to tell you. It's really sunny out today, nice, but it's really cold out there and windy, and the temperature out there is minus 14 degrees Celsius, and it feels like, with the wind, minus 26, and in Fahrenheit, it's 5 degrees Fahrenheit, and it feels like minus 15 with the wind, so there you go. They're predicting we're supposed to have a warmer than usual spring this year, so let's see. It's only March 2nd, right? Or whatever. Just trimming a little bit of the thread off there. That's okay. Okay. Now, what I have here is a doll needle. This one is 3 inches, I think. Or is it 10 inch? Okay. I think I'm going to use this one. Okay, so that's a pretty long needle. That one's even longer. Anyhow, and I need to use, for this, it's a really strong thread. You need to use like a carpet thread, okay? So it's really strong. So I cut a piece off. Oh, that's not long enough. Hang on. Thread it. So I have to thread the needle. Thank goodness the eye is big enough. I can see. It's easy to thread it. So I hope you guys are nice and warm today. I mean, if you're in an area where it's still winter, where it is winter, oh my God. I don't know. It seems like when I turn the camera on, my voice seems to seems to get like raspy for whatever reason, I don't know. Okay. I'm just going to cut the tail a little bit. All right, now. The directions are very simple. I mean, they're very plain. I mean, they don't go into a lot of great detail or explanation, so. And like I said, it's been years since I've made him, so just bear with me. Now it says, okay, thread the needle with carpet thread and push needle from the crotch center. Oh boy, that sounds painful. up through the center front at lower X. Figure one. Okay, so that means here. That right there coming up to there, that's the belly button. So I'm going up through the crotch center. Sorry, guy. Okay. Okay. So you heard a bit of a snap because the knot went inside. Okay, so you're not going to see the end of the thread. Then it says to what? And it says, slide a felt circle onto the needle and push the needle back through the felt and down to the crotch, okay? There's this felt circle. You guys can see what I'm doing. So I just put the little circle on. I wonder if there's enough light for you guys to see. I don't even know, it's sunny out. I should put some light on. Because I'm working on darker fabric, so it might be a little hard for you guys to see. Maybe I should just bring you. Maybe I should just bring you a little closer. So. Okay. Slide the felt circle onto the needle, push the needle back through the felt and down to crotch. Okay. Put it back down in there. Down to crotch. Make like a dimple. Okay. I think I should have centered that a little better. There, that's his belly button. the way that's laying. I don't like how it's on. I can do this because he's not exactly, he's a little bigger than an inch and a quarter. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to trim him a bit. That's not the way to do this. Hang on. Hang on a second. I have to go and get my other scissors. Because I should have maybe put more central. Anyhow, okay. I'm just gonna wish me luck on this. I'm just gonna make them a little smaller. See now what happens. Okay. Well, that's a little better. So that's his belly button. Okay, now what do I have to do? It's all like, it's like petals, but that's okay. He looks okay. And it says, okay, pull thread up to make them fall. Pull the thread to dimple the belly button. Fasten thread securely. Okay, so that means now this is a little bit of a hard part. I have to straighten. Okay. I have to. That means I'm gonna have to knot the thread. Okay, as close as I can. Doing a double, like a double knot. I just want the thread twice. Okay. So to make sure that it's really secure, because the knot's on the outside. I want to sink the knot inside. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the needle back into where the knot is. I don't know if you can see it. See the knot? It's right there. I want to sink the knot back into the there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the needle back into where the knot is, came out. So I have to do this so I can see it. So I'm just pulling it. Sorry. I'm off camera right now because I'm having a hard time seeing it. There. It's going to bring I just want to make sure that it's sunk in there. Okay, the knot's gone inside. Usually you can hear it when it goes, you hear a snap. I didn't hear a snap, but I don't see it, so it's gone inside. So there's the belly button. I have to do the eyes. Just knotting the thread. The same thing, I think. Because the circles, like I said, they're a little bit bigger than they should have been. So what I think I'm going to do is, like the belly button, I'm going to cut them a bit. Make them smaller. So hard to see when you use dark. Something's dark and you have okay. Not a perfect circle, but what can I say, right? Okay. That's okay. The gotta be careful. I'm gonna keep cutting and cutting, and guess what? I have nothing left. Okay. That's better. I hate about working with felt. Make some mess. That's static. Go away. Okay, so done. Now for the eyes. Could it maybe? No, that's fine. Belly button. Okay, for the eyes. Now it says, push needle at center front seam at upper X. And take a couple of back stitches. Push needle through stuffing. Okay, so it says push needle up that center front seam. That's here. Take a couple of back stitches. Okay. That's not going to work. I've done it wrong. Okay. Okay, let's see if I can get this right now. Okay, go up here. Take a couple of back stitches, so this one. Two. That's good. And it says, back stitches, couple packs of push needle through stuffing to one of the eye marks. Okay. Slide a felt circle onto the eye. Okay, slide a circle onto the needle. Push needle back to chin. Okay. Push needle back to chin. I'm just rereading it to push needle through spine to one eye mark, slide a felt circle onto the needle, push needle back to chin and pull up thread to sink eye slightly. Fasten thread without breaking it and make other eye in the same manner. Sink eye slightly. There. Okay. Okay, without sinking it. Okay, slightly. Okay, fasten thread. So I get fasten thread, what do I mean by that? Is that making on? No, just fasten thread. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a knot. I'm going to make a knot, and I'm putting my finger there. So that's to make when a knot tightens, it's going to be right at the thread, right at the point. Okay. Now it says, I have to put the thread back through here. Back through the chin, and I have to make the other eye. Now that thing is, I don't think I had it in the same spot. Anyhow, let's try this. If it's wrong, then I can take it off. Okay. Putting the other eye there. Putting on the other eye. I go back down to the chin. Thank you. Okay, I have to secure it, which means I have to knot it. Now do the same thing as I knot it, just to keep my finger on the knot. So. Didn't work. Jeez. I don't want to sink them that much. One sank more than the other. Which I don't really, I don't want that to happen. I'm just trying to pull it up a bit. Okay. I think that's okay now. I think maybe I should, fix the side a little bit. Better. I think that's okay. Yeah, I have to the knot is too ended up being too far, so I'm gonna sink that knot. Just to hide it so you won't see it. And you just pull this a little bit tight. There. And you don't see anything. Okay. Now. I think he looks okay. What do you think so far? Next, I'm gonna have to clean this. Just such a front, I should have, I gotta clean that off there. Anyway. Now, the nose, you gotta stitch it on. But not with carpet thread. This was feather, regular thread, so I use black thread. I'm not going to use this needle. This needle is too thick for that just to sew that on. Just need a regular needle. On white thread. Okay. Okay. Let's see. How long is it going to take me to thread the needle? I hate that when the thread splits. Look at that. Okay, good. I got it. Okay, come on. Sometimes the fingers just don't want to work. Come on. You on there. You sit there. I just want to put the knot behind. Okay. Enough of this. Come back here. Just putting in there. What are you doing? You're a slippery guy. I have to lay him down. And this is going to be like a whip stitch. Like a blanket stitch, okay? At least I think so. I can't see. table because I can't, I'm having trouble seeing to do this. I don't know if you guys can see what I'm going to be doing. I'm sorry if you can't. But, okay. Trying to position the nose. I'm going to have to go around the edges of the heart of his nose and do like a blanket stitch. Come on. Can't seem to get it. I don't want to squash them too much. As long as I could get the first stitch in. All I need for the thread to knot itself. Oh, boy. Okay, where is it? Just trying to do it so I can see what I'm doing. Just trying to keep them centered. Okay. Once you get the first couple of stitches, it's not so bad. Just gotta pull it and make sure it's tight. so far. So far, so good. Getting there. That's all. How are you guys doing? Hope you're all well and staying safe. Looking forward to the spring. Looking forward to the seeing the trees come to life, buds and the leaves. Listening, that's when the chirp of the baby birds. Let's see. What I do is from my dryer, the lint, I keep that, and then in the spring, what I'll do once the snow is gone, I'll put it outside, because the birds like to collect that for the nests, make their nests. Oh boy. And then the dandelions, when the dandelions first come up in the spring, don't pull them up. Because because that's the first nectar that the bees look for when they first come out from hibernation. So important. That's the first food that they have. Too many left. Not too many stitches left. Almost there. That's the last stitch. Yeah. I'm going to take it. I have to knot it. So I'm going to take this. Go behind the last stitch. Back up and around. So we cannot. No. I'm just gonna go behind. Just to sink it in. And it come up. Come on, honey. As close as I can, fabric, and I'm going to put the needle back in the original hole. Out somewhere else. the needle. Let me see. That's okay. There. One thing missing. Well, one thing, couple of things missing. I have to fix that, like I said. Just a minute. I don't like what I did here. I sunk that eye a little bit too much, but that's okay, you know. A little belly button. Now, let's put the needle in there. So I don't lose it. Now, the eyebrows. I'm going to use the same color wool as I used for his hair. And the thing is, usually I would use embroidery thread, but I don't know where I put my embroidery thread now. I just see something. Okay, it's 4-ply. Let's see. Let's see if I can get it onto this. See if I can get it onto this needle. Okay, it's too thick. I'm going to have to use like I said, I don't know where my embroidery thread is. That's okay, I can use the wool. should do is put a little bit of glue at the end. Or even burn it. Come on. Get in there. Okay. That didn't work. One strand. Maybe I'll just have to use one strand. If you use one strand, I'm going to have to double it, so I have to make it longer. Jeez. I have embroidery floss, but I don't know where it is. That's what happens when you clean up and put stuff away. And put stuff away where? Okay. Okay, let's try this now. You have to put a little bit of glue. Okay. That's for the little bit of glue. There. Just to keep the thread from splitting and fraying up and make it easier, hopefully, to thread the needle. Get in there. Sorry. Okay, there, got it. A thick knot. Now, I know what I did last time, I can't remember, because I'm just gonna, let's see, let's try this one first. Just trying to figure out the length of him. I want to make his eyebrows. It's really hard to let's see. I really don't like the size of that. Okay. Now, I gotta think about how I did this last time. Because you didn't see the knot. And I used, what do you call it? Embroidery thread. So what I gotta do is, I'm going to want to bury the knot. This is not working. Okay. Thread is breaking. I'm going to have to, look for my embroidery thread. Because this is not working with the wool. It tears easy. And I can't get it with a two ply. Let's see, where's the needle? Maybe I can. Let's see. Let's try this again. Okay. Just trying to get the glue off my fingers, my hand. Just trying to get remove the glue off my fingers. Okay, let's try this again with a double, with two strands. Can I thread you? Jeez. Almost get it in and then loop. Okay. Put a looping. There we go. Okay. I'll try to fly. How this works. When I did this, I hit the knot. So, where do I want to come out? Where did I say I was going to make them? Let's just see. Trying to feel where the needle is right there. Let's see. Now, I think what I want to make is eyebrows. This one thickness. Whoever it is will leave a message. If they want to, if not, they'll just. I guess not. Okay. Just to there, or just to there. Because I'm going right through to the other side. That's just it. Take it out. That's it. I have a hard time with this. Just to try to get it even. And get them to the other side. I don't know if the eyebrow maybe is too low. That might be too low. Okay. I'm gonna have to figure out his eyebrows. I think it'll be better if I use a floss. I'm gonna have to look for something else to use for his eyebrows. Anyhow, I'll have to come back to that. What I'm going to do though is I'll sew his vest and I'll put it on him. Just want to move all this out of the way. I gotta get my sewing machine. Got my sewing machine. I'm just going to pin it together. But the back is one piece, right? And the two sides, the front piece, it's a single side. Well, you'll see what I mean when I do it. So I'm just going to pin it here. At the shoulder. Such a little thing. This too. Why is it doing that? Okay, it's okay. Once I get it sewn, I think it'll be okay. That is one also. I'm just going to turn that off. Maybe not. Okay, sewing machine. That there. The foot. I should have enough white thread on there. I'll use this one. Put it on. Okay. Just gotta see which way. Okay. Oh boy. I'll try my machine. No. Try this again. Thread the needle. That's good. Let's see. Thank you. Sure, proper.
Get the foot pedal.
Okay. Side, one side. No, the shoulder. Just clipping the threads. Okay, the other side. Okay. No, nope, it didn't. What happened? My the bottom thread broke. Where is it? Of course, I mean, you know. try this again. Turn it right side out. What I'm going to have to do is, I need to create a hem. So I'm going to finger press this. Opening up the seam on the one shoulder, pressing it down, and on the side. You know what? Just piece that. Same thing on the other side. Crease it with my finger. Six threads everywhere. Come on, go away. I'm just opening up the seams. Okay, now should make a hemmet. What I'm going to do is I'm going to hem it. That means I'm going to have to go all the way around. gonna make a hem. I think I'm just gonna leave it like that. Let's see. I'm not going to make a hem. I'm not going to hem it. But I will do is I'll press it off camera. You don't have to see me ironing. I think I may cut it a little bit shorter. It's a bit too long. Hang on. Let's put this up. There it is. But it's a little vest on. I'll have to do find a floss. I'm not sure if I should leave this hair like this to make it like curly, or I gotta cut. Anyhow, okay, I'll have to make that decision about hemming it or not, or just leaving it like it is, cutting it a little bit shorter. But that's him. But you can't see him. There he is with his little vest on. I have to figure out the eyebrows. Oh, I'll have to figure out the eyebrows, and I'll have to come back to that. A little bit of an eyebrow here, and a little bit of eyebrow on this side. Okay, so there he is, cute little teddy bear, a little bear, hug bear they call him. Anyhow. This, I don't know if you can see him very good. Move my sewing machine. Yeah. It's all got like little pieces of thread on them. I'll get rid of that. I'll have to clean them up a bit. There he is. Like I said, I'll have to clean him up a bit. He's got little bits of threads on him. So there he is. Oops. I'll figure out his eyebrows, and I'll see if I can find my embroidery floss. I don't know where I put it. I had all kinds of colors, so hopefully I'll have this color just to do an eyebrow here, an eyebrow there. That's his little nose, that's his little chin, and that's his little belly button, and a little vest on him. So, that's it, guys. Now, I'll come back, you know, like I said, I'll find the embroidery floss, I'll put it in, I'll put them on, and I'll see if maybe I'll make the vest a little bit shorter, I don't know. I'll just leave it like that. Cute little bear with a belly button. There. Okay. That's it, guys. Like I said, I'll come back. He sits down. Gotta get him. Gotta get him to sit down. You're a little too hot, top. There you go. He's sitting down on his own. Okay, let's see. Can I, maybe? Let me go there. Can I maybe? Hang on, where's... I can't see anything. Jeez. There. So you can see him a little bit. There he is. Anyhow, guys, that's it for today. And, I guess when I come back on, he'll be cleaned up better and maybe have some eyebrows on him. So that's it for today. Hang on a second. Can't find the mouse. All right. There he is. So have a great day, guys. What's today? Today's Tuesday, right? Yeah. Have a great rest of the week, and I'm going to clean them up, like I said. I'm going to try to find my floss, get some eyebrows on them, and get rid of some of the threads, clean them up a bit. And I'll see you guys next time. Ciao!